Okay, so students, today we are going to discuss the next part of our chapter called light. Here we are going to discuss about the plane mirror, means when two mirror are placed at different angle, then how many image will form. Okay, so suppose here we have one mirror. Okay, this is the mirror. One side is painted with the reflecting paint and other side is acting as a reflecting surface. Here we have one more mirror like this. I am just placing them 90 degree with each other. Okay, here we have one more mirror and I have just placed mirror perpendicular with each other. Okay, everyone. So this is the mirror 1, M1, and here we have M2, okay, and that intersection point just I am taking, it is O. So the angle formed between M1 and M2, okay, we are discussing about that angle and we are representing it by A. Okay, so how many image will form? Suppose I have placed one object over here. Suppose this is the object. So how many image will form by this two mirror when object is placed between two mirror when they place at perpendicular to each other? Okay, so we have formula for that.
Three images.
Haan beta? Yes, three images. So we have, how we have you calculated that? With the help of formula or you know it?
No, yes, sir, the formula.
What is the formula? You remember that?
So yes, sir. 360 by 90 minus 1 if it's even.
Yeah, so number of images. Okay. I'm just representing that by N equals to, the formula is 360 degree divided by angle between two mirror minus 1. Okay, so here if you will place the value of A, so let we have the value of angle A is 90 degree. So we have to place that value over here. Okay, therefore number of image N equals to 360 divided by 90 minus 1. So 0 and 0 will get cancelled and 9 fours are 36. So 4 minus 1 is 3. N equals to 4 minus 1 and 4 minus 1 equals to 3. Is it? So the three image will form when two mirrors or plane mirrors are placed perpendicular to each other. Okay. So likewise, you can calculate if the value of angle will be 0 degree, 30 degree, 45 degree, 60 degree, 90 degree, then 120 degree, then 180 degree. Okay, so you just use any value, you will get number of image. Okay, everyone keep replying. And it's when suppose so these two mirror are placed parallel to each other like this, so how many image will form?
But then infinite images.
Yes, if you will kept any object here, so you will see infinite images forming inside, like in the mirror. Okay, so if two mirrors are placed at parallel to each other, then infinity, you even don't able to count. Okay, that much image are going to form. Okay, everyone.
Yes, sir.
Yeah. Okay. So if you want to check, you can like put value like 0 degree, 30 degree, 45 degree, 60 degree, 90, 120 and 180. We already covered for 90 degree. Okay. Suppose we are taking angle between two mirror is 30 degree. So let me change the ink for that. Let A equals to, we have 30 degree beta. So again, we have number of images equals to 360 divided by 30
11 images, 11.
Minus 1. So 0 and 0 will get cancelled. And 3
no, 12.
12s are. So 12 minus 1 is 11. Yes, so number of images will be 11. Okay, so 11 image will form. So I hope you will calculate for any angle it is given right in front of your eyes, means your screen. Is it?
Yes, sir.
Everyone, any doubt beta here? So it is very important concept. So just take a screenshot for that, and you have to just remember that formula. That's all. Okay?
Yes, sir.
Done.
Yes.
Okay. So now, wait a second. I'm just getting call from one student, I think. Okay. So now we are going to discuss the image formed by plane mirror. Okay. So I'm going to discuss important point first. Okay. See, image is forming behind the mirror, is it or not? This is the front part of the mirror, and image is forming behind the mirror, is it or not? Yes. So number one, first point, image formed.
Sir, it doesn't form on the same side of the mirror, right?
Yes, always form behind the mirror, behind the mirror. Such images cannot be projected on screen. Okay. Hence, such images are called as beta virtual image. They are called as virtual image. Okay. Which image are called as virtual image? Those image, they cannot be projected on screen because they are forming behind the mirror. Yes. So images
that cannot obtain.
So image form behind the mirror, hence it cannot be projected on screen. Yes. Therefore
it's called a virtual image.
Yes, image. Therefore, nature of image is virtual image. Understood, everyone? Virtual means those images that cannot be projected on screen are called as virtual image. Understood? Say yes.
Yes.
Everyone say yes.
Yes, sir.
Okay.
Yes, sir.
Okay. Now, next point. Second one. See, this is the downside of the object, and this is the upside. Upside, and this is downside. Downside. Is it?
Yes, sir.
Yes. So, if you are observing the object and image, upside of the object on the image is upside also. So upside up and downside down. Is it?
Yes, sir. It's not upside
down. Yes. Such images are called as erect images. Yes.
Erect or upright.
Yes. Erect image. So the virtual and erect. I'm just joining here only. Virtual and erect. Sorry. This is not working. Yeah, working. Okay, virtual and erect. So what is erect image? When image and objects part like upside up and down side down. Okay, if upside up and downside down, then that image are called as beta erect image. Okay, so now we are going to discuss third point over here. As you can see, suppose this is the person, so that one is the right hand, is it? And it is the left hand. But if you will see in image, that particular part, that part, yes, appears left hand side and that part appears right hand side. Sorry. So, no, it is second point, no? Okay. So, when or image formed by plane mirror, image formed by plane mirror are images formed by plane mirrors are appears like left hand side as right hand side and and right hand side as left hand side. That's all. Okay. So such images are called as inversion in configuration.
The third point is like that they are same size and same distance.
Yes. Such images are called as inversion in configuration. Understood everyone? Inversion or inversion in configuration. Okay?
Yes, sir.
Yeah. So again, take a screenshot. Very important point I am writing here for plane mirror. We are going to complete plane mirror today itself. Done?
Yes, sir.
Okay. Now, next part. Next point. I am erasing the first point. Let me allow to erase the point. Yes. I need the image. Okay. I have to use eraser. Okay. So second point is done. Now we are going to discuss the third point. Okay, third point. See, the size of image, distance, we'll discuss first the distance. Distance of image, or an object from the mirror is represented by U. What is U? It is the distance of object from the mirror. And distance of image from the mirror is represented by beta V. Okay. So for plane mirror, U is always equals to V. Okay. Everyone?
Yes, sir.
Yes. So, just you have to remember what is V and what is U. U is the image of the object from the mirror and V is image distance from the mirror. Okay? That's all. Means U equals to V. Fourth point, very important. The distance from object to the image is always double than V or U. V means what? The distance of image from the mirror or U, what is U?
Yes. Paper, it means, so like if 1 meter away from mirror, that means 2 meter away from image.
Yes. So U is nothing but we already written over here. What is U? It is the distance from object to mirror. It is always half than the distance between image and object. Okay. Everyone understood?
Yes, sir.
Okay. So it is really very important. Next, fifth point. Suppose if you want to observe your full image on the mirror, then mirror must be half the height of yours. Whatever the your height, that image form, if you want to form the full image of your body from top to bottom, then mirror must be half of the height than your length. Okay, so I'm just going to write fifth point here. If
sir, half or double your height?
No, half. Okay. So if you want to observe your full image on plane mirror, on plane mirror, then the mirror must be half the height of object. That's all. Okay. Everyone, do reply.
Yes, sir.
Yes.
So I double it, or else it's equal to you. It won't form which.
Hamita.
Sir, like if it's your the object height or like double the object height, will the image be formed or the full image?
No, I'm not getting your point.
Sir, like if the mirror's height is like your height, will your image be still on the mirror?
Wait a second.